sein, meine Kaufmann. Schau da nochmal Whitney, schau da nochmal Kitty. Juli ist da noch Arbeit von meiner kleinen Kenny Fidi. Majesta ist mein Liebe, Tante Brenda ist mein Twinny. Und der Monster nicht vergeten, Tante Mena ist mein Hatti. Auf meinen Arm bin ich dankbar, kijk mir nau. Du ist mir auch ein Grüe von der Kind nach Frau. Nog steeds staat u altijd klaar voor mij. Ik laat u never in de steek, altijd aan u zij. En deze is voor allemaal superwoman. Dit komt van diep uit mijn hart.
Here we go. What's going on? Oh, y'all up this late? This crazy, y'all up? Peace, peace. Y'all really up this late? Or this early? What's going on, y'all? That's crazy. That's crazy, y'all. I'm listening to that. What's it going? I'm listening to that. Yo, Master Fani, I haven't seen you in a while. I haven't seen you in a while. Where have you been at? I'm out here listening to that Dutch music. I listen to Dutch music. This music is yo, I got this many people on? That's crazy. No way. What's going on? I got this many people on this evening? Damn, this might be my new time. What's going on, y'all? Grand evening to all. Grand evening, grand rising, whatever time it is for y'all. I hope. That's crazy. I didn't even think this was. When I hear music now. Look. Yeah, what's it called? More, what's it called? Because of this heightened energy, you're going to feel things more. Because of this heightened energy, you know. You're going to feel things more. You're going to be able to see more things, more light, more colors are probably going to be popping out to you. You're going to be able to tap in into different frequencies, different dimensions. You're going to be more tactile. It's going to be more tactile. So when you feel things, you're going to feel more description, more characteristics about specific things, because your awareness is ascending. You're aware. You're becoming more aware of your of who you are and what you are, your environment. So more light is being entered into your body. That's literally what's happening. It's more awareness, more consciousness, more light, more of who and what you are is basically being downloaded into your physical vessel every single day. So it's kind of like how can I say this? You can equate it to like how, or hold on. You can equate it to how it's just like water, you know? Water takes the shape of the vessel that it's in. So you are in like a, you are in a smaller container. You are in a smaller container to hold that water. So now your container is growing more. More water is coming in. So now your container is going to have to grow as well. Your physical vessel is definitely changing. Just be aware of that. But it's going to take time. More light's going to be more present. So what's happening now is more light, right? More light's entering the physical vessel. More light's entering the physical vessel. And it's going to start portraying on your physical vessel. Your physical vessel is going to start changing. A lot of people, if you notice, if you go out into the sun, you're going to see you're glowing. People are going to see that you are glowing. You are glowing, literally, I'm saying. And then when you do that, you go out there, you notice your body's changing over time. And then you're accumulating more light, so you're becoming more luminous. And then once you make the shift into the next dimension, that's when your body changes. But I ain't come, what's it called? I ain't come to... I couldn't share all that stuff. Even though, it's crazy. I didn't even expect everybody offline. I expect so many people to be up this late. Truth be told, it's like 2:18 over here. I was doing research because I wanted to come. I wanted to come and present and do a presentation. I got a fire ass presentation that I wanted to do. I wanted to do this evening, but I ran out of time. I kept on going because I kept on finding more interesting things, more and more interesting things. And I want to share that with y'all, but I was like, well, this evening is too late, so I'll just do it tomorrow. But yo, we could just kick it and chill. We can just chill and kick it. A God has sent me this stuff right here, and I was just looking through it. And I've said this before, y'all. They give no fucks now. All cards, all everything, all decks on the table right now. Pardon me. This is how you know they are desperate. This is how you know they are desperate. Okay. I don't want to go. But this is on the internet now. Like, if it's on the internet, it's like, you really don't care. You really don't care. But yeah, let's just look at this, y'all. Hold on, I'm gonna show y'all this. What's going on, y'all? How y'all doing? Do you think deja vid? I'm thinking you mean deja vu. Do you think deja vu moments mean that we've already lived that moment? All right, what's it called? I explained this before, but I'm gonna explain this real quickly because you probably weren't here yesterday. But the way that you're told time works doesn't work like that. Okay, you think, or most people think time is linear. Most people think time is linear, where, okay, I'm in set motion now and all I gotta do is move forward. No, time doesn't work like that. Time doesn't work because time doesn't exist. Time is not real. You know what I'm saying? Your perception of time is predicated upon your consciousness, your awareness, what's going on in your mind here. So time doesn't exist to, that's why time doesn't exist to higher dimensional beings. You only perceive time because you're told to look at time a certain way. The only thing that makes time exist is clocks. That's the only reason why you think time exists. Clocks is the only reason why you think time exists. Time doesn't exist. Clocks are the only thing that exists. So, this is the way that time works. You are consciousness itself, right? You are consciousness itself. You're nothing but consciousness. You're not even this physical vessel. You're not this physical vessel at all. You are projecting through this physical vessel. So time works like this. Like this. Time is parallel, right? Time is parallel. Time is parallel, okay? So say for instance, hold on, y'all. Say for instance, this is our dimension right here, our reality, right? Say for instance right here, this is our reality. Well, this is my piece of consciousness in this reality, right? And this is your piece of consciousness in this reality. This is John Bender. This is LaPel Payne. This is Joe Sun. You know, everything right here. But you also have a piece of consciousness in this timeline. You have a piece of consciousness in this timeline. You have a piece of consciousness in this timeline. You have a piece of consciousness in this timeline. You have a piece of consciousness this time. You have a piece of consciousness in every timeline, okay? You just choose to focus your consciousness that is this frequency right here in this timeline. This is where you're choosing to focus your consciousness, your reality, this consciousness, because all the decisions that you've made throughout your whole time brings you to this reality right here. It brings you to this reality right here. You are constantly flip-flopping between these realities, but you're not aware of this. You're not aware of this because time doesn't exist. That's why you're not aware of flip-flopping between dimensions as well. So you are living this reality right here. And when you experience deja vus, it's like, because we're still moving, right? When you experience deja vus, you come in contact with one of your parallel realities, like this. So we're in this reality, right? Say, for instance, you experience a deja vu. Maybe this reality and this reality mix, because this brought you to a point of time where you guys had the same thought process in two different realities. That's what happens. So say, for instance, if you went to Whole Foods, everybody know Whole Foods, right? Say, for instance, you went to Whole Foods in this dimension. Well, in a parallel dimension, you made the same decision to go to Whole Foods at the same time. And then you guys end up meeting in this parallel time space right now. Your consciousness, because you're a consciousness itself, right? You're not the body. You are consciousness itself. So your two points of consciousness meets right here in the same dimension, the same time portal, and you experience what's called deja vu, because you're made the same decision at the same time in different aspects of parallel realities. Same shit. You know what I'm saying? You get me? So that's kind of like the simplest form to explain deja vu. You know what I'm saying? That's the simplest form of explaining deja vu. Y'all get that? But yeah, so what's it called? Yeah, you're going again. More awareness is coming to the planet. Pardon me. More awareness is coming to the planet. Everything is light itself. Everything is light itself. Light emanates from darkness. Okay? So light is information. Everything is light. Everything is light. The only reason why you were lacking your psychic abilities or your powers, because the amount of light that you needed in order for your DNA to be activated was not on the planet. There was a shadow. Right? So you were not receiving the light that you needed in order to have your powers, okay? So we live in a shadow aspect of the higher dimensions, okay? So how can I say this? We are light beings, luminous beings. So you need your abilities in order to move and facilitate through the higher dimensions. So in the 3D, you don't need this shit, because 3D is density. It's dense. You know, you can't fly. You can't do any of that things. You can't manifest things of how you want to. Now, in the fourth and fifth dimension, you can manifest things. So this requires more light. This requires more light, and this unlocks your DNA. So we've been in the third dimension, which is a shadow aspect of the fourth dimension. In the fourth dimension, there's more light, more awareness, more consciousness. You activate powers right now because you are unity consciousness. You become one with everything. Okay? You can only have powers when you become one with everything, because again, the saying goes, with great power comes great responsibility. So enclosed into a dimension where it's dense, right? Where you require a physical vessel, right? So this is the 3D world right here. This is the 3D world right here, where it's dense. You can't really do too much, right? Hold on. Matter of fact, let me do this. Let me do this instead. Let me do this instead. All right. Say, for instance, we're in a fishbowl, right, y'all? We're in a fishbowl, right? We're in a fishbowl, as you know. Right? We're in a fishbowl. So now in this fishbowl, light is contained. Light is moving slow. So you are dense. You are dense. You become physical. You manifest in physical because of the fishbowl effect. You are dense. You are dense. You're not as light, as luminous that you need to be in order to access your abilities. So what's happening is you are in the shadow aspect of this 4D world or ether world, because the ether is everything. Okay, so this is the whole ether world right here. This is the whole ether world right here. And this requires more light in order to have your abilities, okay? Your abilities to be accessed into the dimension. So what happens is you contain in this fishbowl where light is slowed down, and you don't have the sun that you need in order to create access your abilities. So you're in this fishbowl where that's just getting this projected light source from the outside sun that you're not even getting your real sun from. So that's why you don't have no abilities, because you're not even getting the real sun that you need. So now the real sun is getting closer to you. It's accessing more light, more energy is being permeating through there, more gamma ray energy, and it's permeating through this glass, through this magnetic field, right? It's breaking down the magnetic field, because if you see this, look, I'm not, as you know, this shit just came out a couple of days ago, right here. New huge sunspots triples in size in 24 hours. This was just a few days ago, right here, on the 29, right here, on the 29. And hold on, y'all. So now you see these huge ass sunspots, right? You see these huge ass sunspots? So that shit just doubled in size in less than 24 hours. So all we need at that point of time is a solar flare type of event in order to catapult us. So now all that light from the sun is permeating throughout this glass right here. And it's breaking down the magnetic field, this glass right here, this fishbowl is breaking down the magnetic field. So now you're getting more light, the necessary light in order that you need. No, now you're becoming more luminous. You're going to start to ascend. You're going to start become faster and more brighter than what you were being in this light. So it's called light code lockdown. It's light code lockdown because your light has been on lockdown. The real light that was you has been on lockdown because you were not connected to the real light that you needed, which is the sun that's coming right now, the red sun and the blue sun, because everything is electromagnetism, isn't it? Everything is electromagnetism. If you're missing an aspect of yourself, how can you be your real self? How can you be the real self if you're missing the aspect of yourself? You can't. You were contained in this bubble your whole life, or for whatever many lifetimes you've been in here, you've been reincarnated in here. So you were kept from your abilities. So now the very thing that's keeping you from your ability is being destroyed by the very thing that you are, which is the sun. Now you're going to get your abilities now. So you're going to feel more hot, more gamma energy is going to enter your body and change your DNA, okay? Because being in here and also changing, altering your mind through predictive programming, because that's what they've been doing with the television. They've been programming your mind for whatever reason that may be. And this causes you to change over time because you are the creator. So if you're telling the creator what it is, If you're telling the creator something that it isn't, it's obviously going to create that reality for you over time, because that's how the mind works. That's how thought works. Everything is thought itself. Nothing exists but thought. All this physicality only exists because of thought. This is light slowed down to the most slowest form possible, the slowest particle. That's the only reason why I seem physical or you seem physical. Everything else is just thought. Nothing else exists but thought. As you know, that's why they say atoms is 99.9% empty space. The only thing that 1% is thought itself. That's the only thing that exists. It's thought. Literally. Everything is thought. Nothing else exists but thought. So your thought holds weight. Your thought holds weight. Think about that. Your thought holds weight. The most difficult item to manifest into this physical world is here. What would be the most what would be the most difficult item in your opinion to manifest into this physical world? In your opinion, what would be the most difficult item in this physical world would be your opinion to how difficult it is. You know what I'm saying? And it goes to show you how much your thoughts hold weight. They are dense. They are very, very dense. Think about it, how long it takes. Think about how long it takes for you to manifest something in this physical reality. And that goes for money as well, too. If you wanted $200 million, it would take you a lot longer to manifest $200 million as opposed to looking for $10. You know what I'm saying? If you have no idea how to connect with your thoughts, with the higher supreme consciousness that you are, that will be able to manifest anything that you want to the physical dimension, it's going to be hard for you to do this. You know what I'm saying? The only thing that ever exists is darkness itself. Sound, vibration. That's darkness. You can't see anything unless it starts to vibrate at a certain frequency. You won't be able to see it. That's sound. That's darkness. That's just vibration itself. Darkness. Again, you only see me because of the light that exists. You only see me because of the light that exists. If there was no light, I wouldn't be here. Would it? Would I? Where'd I go? You know what I'm saying? That's the only reason why you see me. Because the light. So that is the true aspect of who and what we are. You know what I'm saying? But yeah. So I just wanted to get on there, you know, share a little thing with y'all. But that's not even what I really wanted to come talk about, truth be told, but you know, but it's a good thing to teach. It's always good to teach. So more light is entering this physical reality and changing us and making us go into metaphysical. You're becoming light, okay? You're becoming light. There's different forms of matter, okay? And you are becoming light. But let me... Can I make a video about that? Honestly, y'all, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I've been feeling so... I have not been motivated to post videos as much. I'd rather come on here and just kick some knowledge. You know what I'm saying? I just rather come on here and kick some knowledge, put some information out there. The videos is not really... I really don't care about that no more. I just wanted to get out there and put some information so people can hear my truth. My truth, because this is what I'm living. But it's not right now. I'm not feeling called to share anything. You know what I'm saying? I'm not feeling called to share anything at this moment. I have been saving videos to speak on it, but it's like by the time I speak on it, it's just already old news. And then it's like, it doesn't interest me anymore at that point in time. So I just rather not even, I don't know, you know. And it's like, damn, if I talk about stuff, I know it's gonna go there. It's gonna get what I need. But it's not even about that. I really don't care. I'd rather come on here and kick some information, kick some knowledge. People ask, I got some questions. If I can answer it, then that's cool. If not, then we have a whole bunch of intelligent beings on here that can definitely answer questions. This is what we do. We got to get to know one another and see what other thought processes are. We are one of another. You know what I'm saying? It's the great big thought. This is what we're all part of. The great big thought. You are part of this as well. So we're just thought coming together to be thought itself, to create literally. So that's literally what it is. But let's do what thoughts do today, and we gonna do some thought exploring, okay? Let's be a thought. Hold on. First of all, damn, it's late as hell, y'all. Hold on, y'all. We gonna listen to a little dust music right quick. Hey, what? Let me use the bathroom right quick. Hold on. Let me use the bathroom. I'll be right back. Thank you.
kracht als ik denk aan haar. Ik know dat Glenda Milo, she's my shining star. En deze is voor allemaal superwoman. Dit komt van diep uit mijn hart. Mama, ik heb respect als ik kijk naar jou. Ik wou niet altijd aan je zijn, maar ik hou van jou. Shout out naar mijn Whitley en shout out naar mijn Titi. Jullie staan nog altijd voor me klaar, ik ken die Firi. Majesta is mijn liefie, tante Brenda is mijn twinnie. En de mooiste niet vergeten, tante Mena heeft mijn artie. En oma, ik ben u dankbaar, krijg me nou. U heeft me op een groeien van een kind naar vrouw. Nog steeds staat u altijd klaar voor mij. Ik laat u never in de steek, altijd aan u zijn. En deze is voor allemaal superwoman. Dit komt van diep uit mijn hart. Shoot, mijn telefoon die gaat af. Is voor Firi al bed. Met een movie gecatcht. Ik kijk je aan, jij kijkt me aan. Ik voel mijn hart in mijn nek. Weet dat jij me nu gaat vragen wie zijn nummer is dat. Ik voel die heat al langzaam komen. Dus ik stap uit je bed. Ik kijk hem aan, die bisse ogen. Ik besef het gaat lep. Ik maak het met mij.
You hear that shit? That shit sound hard, boy. Hey.
Ik maak je dek. Ik heb je vaker gezegd. Je moet niet met mijn Firi spelen.
What?
Ik ben gek. Daarom breek ik je bek.
I don't even know what they say, but that shit sound hard. But this shit just makes me want to sag my pants, put another couple chains on, put a couple watches on, take off my crystals, and just throw up, get some girls. Yo, you see how dangerous music is? You see how dangerous music is? This shit just be... Where my shades at, huh? Where my shades at? Where my neck? Where my other chain at, huh? This shit just be... Where my hair? Yeah. Just... Yo, music is dangerous, you know what I'm saying? But... So... Hold on, y'all. What's going on, y'all? I love y'all too, you know what I'm saying? Let me see. Look, check this out. Like I was saying before, they don't give a... Oh, appreciate love that, Pixie. Appreciate love that. Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate love that. I'm so grateful. But like I was saying before, they really don't give no fudge of what's going on anymore, because this is it dark in here? Oh, the music was playing. But what's it called? Because this system is breaking down and they need as much help as they need as much help. So they're putting this right there in your face, advertising right here. Look, check this out, y'all. Look, they like no fuzz whatsoever. Look at this. Look. Hold on, y'all.
Initiation process.
Hail Satan, full of might. Our allegiance is with thee. Cursed are they. The God adorers.
Look at this.
And cursed are the worshippers.
Join us today and get financial assistance from the Brotherhood.
Do you see what they're pushing? Do you see what they're pushing? Hold on.
The Brotherhood doesn't discriminate. We spread love. We're all equal in the eyes of Lord Lucifer. Everyone is free to apply to become a member, but few are chosen.
You hear that?
Because they know the value of becoming a great man. Join us today and get financial assistance from the Brotherhood. Hail Lucifer. The Brotherhood doesn't.
Look, y'all, they have.
How many cars do you see in my yard? Drop a comment with correct answer and stand a chance to win $500. Hail the light.
Now, I want you guys to know, when they're talking about, as from my last live, which was, I believe, yesterday, Hold on. What's it called? As my last live. Yeah, look.
Thanks to the Illuminati, I received my fifth benefits as a member.
You cannot make this. Look, this is a ritual that he's about to go through. He's regretting it. And they're telling him no.
Non-refundable.
Too late.
Where's our reimbursement?
Look, he looked like he's regretting it.
Right behind it.
So they give no fucks anymore because, you know, the system is breaking down. So they need as many people.
Look at this. Make good men better.
I can't believe it. This is on TikTok.
Businessmen and women, lawyers, accountants, bus drivers, no matter what you do, you're encouraged to apply to become a member and get financial assistance from the Brotherhood. We're making good men better.
Accountants, you know, I'm really proud of that.
Now, they said, you know, anyone can apply, but only few are chosen. So as you can see, they're not hiding anything anymore. They're putting it. It's first of all, they never hid anything in the first place. It's always been in your face. It's only if you were aware of this or not. It's always been in your face. Don't mistake that. They were just a little bit better at hiding it. But now it's just really out there because this shit's over. The game is over. The game is literally over. As you know, the light won. And if you can't tell, you must not be feeling the sun out there, because that light is strong and it's going to keep permeating. Remember, we are stuck in this environment, and we must go back to what we are. You know what I'm saying? And this ain't it. You know what I'm saying? We're trapped in here and this ain't it. We want to get out and basically go back to our lives. This was only fun for a moment of time, and we have to go. Funny enough, they always put the truth in your face, because I was doing more research on the whole Carbon 7 thing. Now, if y'all know, Sakbase, what's going on? Zo Pound 1123, Sakbase. When are the two suns coming? You don't feel that sun? You don't see that out there? Look, I showed this before, y'all. Look, the sun's already here. People just aren't aware of this. Look, they show you this right here. Again, so this is the projection of the sun. This is the projector right here. But then you have a huge object behind that projection. There's something behind this projection right here. There's something behind the projection over here. Look. So depending on where you're at, again, everything is perception. So someone with a high vibration or a camera with a high vibration, high resolutions are able to pick up on different things. And then because every dimension is 90 degrees, every time you turn 90 degrees, you're basically in a new dimension. You see things from a different perspective, you know, the number 9. So And according to this, you can see things like this, because what this shows you is that how we're literally in a fishbowl again on a flat plane. You have the projection out there, right? So this is going to show, this is going to show on the inside. This is going to show on the inside right here. There's a huge object around here. So this is going to reflect on the inside. You're going to see this huge halo behind it. And it is so true. And it's so true that even the moon has moon dogs. They call it moon dog. The moon has something behind it as well. And people are not, I don't know if people are aware of that, but even the moon has these so-called dogs. Hold on, let's look. Yeah. Moon dogs, look. So there's also something behind the moon. There's something behind the moon, behind the light of the moon, which they tell you uses the light of the sun. Makes no sense whatsoever, because why do you see the moon in the daytime as well? It makes no sense. But and how ironic they call it a dog, because it has to do with the planet Sirius, with Sirius saying sun dog. Okay. But yeah, so there is something literally behind this projector that is literally going to destroy this magnetic field that's literally holding this illusion together. And they show you this. They show you this in plenty of things. I've showed you plenty little films and plenty little films where they show like the dome being projected here, or causing the flash flood, the flash throws that basically causes the whole dome being placed in the middle of the earth. It shows people that's outside trying to get to the dome. And whenever people try to get to the dome, then things are disrupted because they have sensors all over the earth. And whenever people try to come in, they know. Again, that's how they knew to attack Black Jesus when he first entered the earth, when he first entered this realm. Because everything is monitored. Because again, this has to be done at the highest orders. This is not literally little gray aliens doing this. You know what I'm saying? This thing is being done at the highest orders. Again, because this is just a test for us. But people are going to see. Literally, this has literally been a test, and we are in the midst of it. But that's what I wanted. I wanted to do a little bit of the Hold on, what time is it? It's 13. Y'all wanna listen to a real life abduction story? Y'all wanna listen to an abduction story? It's about 19 minutes long. Y'all wanna listen to an abduction story? First of all, Jimothy, you don't belong here, so get out of here, bro. All right, so I'm gonna be talking about this, just giving a little bit of noise in the background, because as I talked before, these abductions are made by grays, or what they call the custodians. I started listening to it. I didn't finish it. I'm only 2 minutes in, but they refer to these grays as the custodians, because these are the ones that basically have taken the. I have so much shit to show y'all. Basically, you know what I'm saying. But basically, the stuff that they're trying to push right now, right? Y'all know what I'm talking about. I don't have to say anything. The stuff that they're trying to push right now, right? This changes your mRNA. Now, what's happening is a lot of people's bodies are breaking. The fuck? There's something just happened. What happened? Something just happened. Something just happened on my phone. I don't know what just happened. Okay. Okay, so what's happening is a lot of people's bodies are breaking down, okay? I'm not going to say too much, but yeah. So these people that are getting abducted, they're getting abducted by their future selves. Now, remember what I said. Okay. Remember what I said. Okay. Can y'all dang, I don't know how to. Alright. So right here you got the present. You got the past, present, future. Past, present, future, right? So we are right here. You have the utmost past where you are basically nothing, okay? Where in this earth you are nothing as yet. And then you have the timeline, the future, where you are the most higher existential part of yourself. You are the supreme, okay? Being able to basically, you are your higher self, and you basically become, you can materialize into the metaphysical, into the physical if you want to. So you're just pure energy, pure consciousness at this point in time around here. But you can manifest in a physical vessel if you want to. So this is where you basically don't need any technology whatsoever, okay? Because you understand that you are the technology, you are the very essence of technology itself. Technology is literally made up after you. So you don't need anything because you are everything. You understand this. All right, now you live in this reality. We live in this reality right here in this present. So what happened is these things were created to basically be given to certain type of groups of people to basically cause their body to break down, right? To break down during the process and cause their essence to eject out of their body. So now what happens is the very beings of that future that had their essence ejected out of their physical vessel, which would be the Greys, because they are biomechanical robots, they come back into our timeline, okay, to figure out what the hell happened and try to stop this shit before it's too late. At the same time, abducting people to compose tests on them to figure out how they can connect the soul back into the physical vessel. So this is who the Greys are. This is what the Greys are. So if y'all want to, we're gonna listen to this abduction story real quick. Alright, y'all. Let's get it. Yo, Pops, what's going on, guy? How you doing, Pops? I see you in here. Me and Pops be joking. That's my brother. Pops, that's my brother. Alright, let's get it. So, and I want y'all to know there's a reason why there's multiple companies making that. Okay, there's a reason why multiple companies are making that, or we're making that, or right now they are making that right now. Because why? They're talking about what's it called? Didn't New York and California just declare a state of emergency? Yeah, for this thing that's going on right now, this monkey thing. You know what I'm saying? I think New York and California just declared a state of emergency. So they're literally trying to push this thing in your face again. I said this, and this has nothing to do with that. Just understand that it has nothing to do with that. This has to do with what's going on, okay? They're trying to cover up what's going on because they're trying to find a way to make you stay inside, okay? This has nothing to do with what you think is going on. nothing to do with that, okay? People's bodies are breaking down because of this, and they're trying to recover this up. So they are creating more of this in order to basically cause your body to break down even more, okay? They're going to cause it, whatever, in order to keep you staying inside the house, just to let you know. Just to let you know that. But yes, there's a reason why multiple companies are making this and then making certain races of people take different kinds of these things. Now, I specifically remember a lady talking about this. She signed up to take it. And then when she went to the place to take it, which was a CVS, when she went to the place, they basically came out with the wrong one. When she gave her name, they were like, "Oh, I apologize. This one is not for you. It's for someone else." And they were like, "What you mean it's for someone else? Because aren't we supposed to be taking the same thing?" And it was like, "Nope." Now, mind you, this lady was melanated. The lady was melanated, but the shot that they were going to give her was for a non-melanated. So again, this goes to show you that these companies that are making these things are specifically targeting specific individuals because, again, there's people's bodies that are breaking down during this time and they're trying to cover this up. I'm not lying. I'm not. All right, let's listen to this. What's it called? This real life abduction story. Now, it's a reenactment, but this whole thing is real. Okay, this whole thing is real. There are people who are out there literally getting taken up by these, you know, these extraterrestrial beings that came from our future into our present or their past. If that makes sense, I know that makes sense because y'all are intelligent. All right, let's get it. Look, I got a hell of a presentation for y'all coming soon.
Don't be afraid, human. You cannot touch us because we are nowhere spatially near you. Your eyes are in fact closed, and all you see now are images we are projecting in your head. Where am I? What's going on? You, as in your...
What's it called? Is it something to be afraid of? What? No, hold on. Someone asked... Explain how and why they're being taken. The reason why that they are being taken, I'm going to explain this one more time. The reason why they are being taken is because their body is breaking down. Their body is breaking down. And these things were invented as a way. Okay. How can I explain this a little better? Okay. There is a created race here. The created race here, okay, which we know as white people. Their body was created in the form of putting multiple cell organism within the vessel. So now, because of this ascension that's happening right here, the sun is shining more light into this world. So now this is sending gamma radiation energy into them, okay? Now, what's happening is the gamma radiation is affecting multiple proteins, multiple cell organisms within that physical vessel. This is a problem. This is a problem because what's happening is it's multiple entities or multiple animals, what I should say, is in this physical vessel. So now the sun doesn't know which one to basically to ascend or descend. So it's confusing. So you have multiple organisms trying to communicate with each other, and they can't not at this point of time because they're different beings. They're different entities within that vessel, within that cell, within that nucleus. Okay, so because they don't know which being to basically talk to or Or, you know, the beings cannot communicate with another, the body starts breaking down. And these things were invented as a safeguard in order to for them to take it, so it can, so those messengers, those proteins within that cell organism, within that nucleus, can communicate with each other and cause their body to ascend as well. And this is what these things were about. This is why these things were created. This is why these things were created. It has nothing to, it has everything to do with, that's why it's coming out with the sun. That's why it's coming out around the same time with the sun. Because the sun is what's causing their bodies to break down. Literally. Literally. And I'm gonna prove this. I mean, I proved this before, but I'm just gonna, I think the what's it called? The presentation I'm gonna do tomorrow is gonna go, is gonna tap into a little bit of this again. So I hope y'all understand that. You know what I'm saying? I hope y'all understand that. So the people who were, so the vessels of the people who were created, that's what's happening to y'all, literally. So the grays are basically human beings that have, who have evolved over time, who's coming back into this timeline to figure out what went wrong and try to basically connect the soul back into the physical vessel again and try to stop it from breaking down. So they are the ones who creating this, who they are actually the ones who are creating these things. They are just the ones. They are the ones creating these things. You think it's the government that's creating this shit? No, these are these extraterrestrials who coming back into our time, who's coming back from the future into our timeline in order to make these things and give it to them in order to help their body ascend. That's exactly what it is. I hope y'all understand that.
Your consciousness, or you as in your corporeal body. What? At the moment, your body is on Earth. Your consciousness is now with us. We are a peaceful network, an infinite minority of us from your plane and universe, but infinitely, mostly not. Don't worry, as we have custodians watching over your body while we speak with you here.
You hear that? Custodians.
Custodians? My body? You mean I'm dead? Yes, custodians. Before connecting with you, we arranged for your dog Kuya to leave his soft toy on your basement floor to ensure your head had a safe landing when you hit it. We also arranged for
speak on this before. So now, let me give you how fourth dimension works, right? Let me give you how dimensions work. These are fourth and fifth dimensional entities. Okay? They can tap in into this dimension whenever they want to, at will. At will. I want you to know that. So they can manipulate situations in this dimension. Did you hear what he just said? He said, we made sure there was a toy underneath your head so when you fall down, you don't hurt yourself. They can manipulate. They can make things manifest into this physical dimension without you being aware of it. You know how sometimes your shit, your car keys disappear, or your toy disappear, or something disappeared, because they literally disappear into another dimension. They can do that. They can do that. The reason why they don't do that is because this is the prime directive. They can't infringe on your free will. That's why you have to ask for help. Whenever a situation like this happens, whenever something happens, you have to ask for help. And then when you ask for help, then they can help. You ever see on TV shows or on movies, right? You ever see on TV shows and in movies, and they are looking at the Earth. They're looking at the Earth from the bottom perspective, from the higher up perspective, right? From the higher up perspective, like they're looking at the Earth and they're looking at how they're the U.S. got ships on the side of it. You know what I'm saying? From that type of perspective, it's because they're able to manipulate it, because these are higher beings looking at Earth from that perspective. They're not humans. They're not humans. So they're able to enter things into this simulation. This is a game. Remember, this is a game. This is a matrix. Nothing is real. Everything is just thought. So they can manipulate this reality as thought. So just like you, how, for instance, there's an ant walking by, right? There's an ant walking by. Well, you can put a ball in front of the ant, and the ant's going to be like, what the fuck? How did that ball get here? How the fuck did that ball get here? It was not here just a second ago, and now it's here because you are a higher dimensional being that can operate of it. So the ant lives in the shadow aspect of you. You can manipulate their reality for them because they are two-dimensional beings. You are third-dimensional beings. You can fuck with their reality without them knowing that it was you, and then they're going to be thinking it's God or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? They have no idea you exist in their world. They have no idea until you come fuck with their world. Then they're like, oh, shit, that's God. God damn, dog, God is black as fuck. That nigga dark. You know what I'm saying? That's what the ants be saying. You know what I'm saying? They got some big toes. All right, let's continue with this.
Westward blowing winds to shut your door after your fall and conspired with dust mites to ensure you breathe them in and increase the mucus in your lungs and throat to protect your body from getting too cold too fast. You are not dead, but alive.
Now, I want you to, I hope you heard what he said. He said dust mites. So now the dust mites, these are the Morgellons. These are smart dust technology. Now, every single person has dust mites within you. This is also how they know who you are, what you are, where you're at, and all that type of stuff. Let me ask you a question. you think Elon Musk creating Neuralink is something new? You think Elon Musk creating Neuralink is top of the line technology? You think having something that's going to connect with, you think, hell no. Hell no. These, again, the technology comes after you. Everything, all the technology that's being created, whatever, it comes from you. They don't need none of that shit. That Neuralink, it's a cheap joke. It's a joke. It's pretty much a play at this point in time. So, they don't need none of the technology. Literally. These beings are so advanced. They're so advanced they can manipulate you just by the thought of it. And that's what I want to touch upon that in the next presentation.
Hold on. And currently unconscious.
My God. Yeah, I'm allergic to dust.
You're actually allergic to dust mite feces. Not dust.
You hear that?
Most of the dust you breathe in actually comes from your own body. The mites are defecating in your lungs now as they drown in your mucus.
You hear that?
They agree.
So these dust mites or these Morgellons are literally killing you from the inside out. Okay? They're literally killing you from the inside out.
They to offer themselves to keep you from becoming ill while you were connecting with us for this meeting. Disgusting. Everyone is delighted at this titanic connecting.
Okay, you're obviously an omnipotent race. Why am I here and what are you going to do with me?
Now, did you hear what he said? You're obviously an omnipotent race. Again, didn't I just say, if you are a higher dimensional being, you can manipulate lower realities. You can bend lower realities to your will to make it seem like you are omnipotent. You are bigger and more powerful than those beings. So these God entities, okay, these Elohim, these fallen angels of the Bible or whatnot, these are nothing but just extraterrestrials who are basically playing God on this world. That's literally what they are. They are extraterrestrials come into this physical reality and playing God, making you forget that you are God. Literally, that's what they're doing. They're manipulating, and then they basically give you the illusion of a devil living and all this type of stuff. This devil that's coming here. If you don't go to hell, what's it called? Even the Pope admit that hell doesn't exist. What did y'all hear about that? Even the Pope, this was a few years ago. The Pope said hell doesn't exist. What happened to Christianity? Wasn't Christianity supposed to fall at that point in time? I don't understand that. You know what I'm saying? I don't understand that. But let's continue with this, okay? Hold on.
Do not be afraid. We will not harm you. We will also reward you at the end of this connecting.
Which one of you is talking to me right now?
We all are. As are all planets, solar systems, galaxies, universes, and planes, and its beings. In fact, all entities from all planes are tapped in right now, listening to this conversation. We are all on the edge of our seats in eager discovery. This event is comparable to when you humans first landed on your lunar satellite.
What do you mean? So, you guys are aliens and I'm your first abduction?
Yes and no. Yes, we have never before connected with a human, but we are now tapped into approximately 5,407,003 human consciousnesses from different places of Earth, from different times, from the very first primal human
beings. First of all, dog slapper, go slap some dogs, okay? Ain't nobody wanted you in here in the first place, man. You look like a dog in the first... Man, you know what? I'm not even going to say nothing.
To the last genetic human of your ever-evolving species.
You mean you guys can travel time? You've abducted cavemen.
We are not as a whole bound by time. You say and think words like first and communicate and think with tenses. Where we, meaning the infinite majority of our consciousness, are from, we do not have that. Time is a component that exists only in your universe, as well as several others born from your metaverse, the parent of your universe. Your universe is actually the second generation of universe to possess the aspect known as time, which should make you feel quite special considering your universal lineage continuum is infinite. We are currently tapped into approximately 5,407,003 humans, which includes you, from various earthen places, from different years all at once. There is no sequence, and this human consciousness sample brings us great information. We are in celebration at this connection. To help you understand, by
So basically what he's saying is their creation, they got them tapped. They are literally, they know who and what you are all the time. You guys ever hear of, this is a story right now. You guys ever hear of abduction stories? And I know this. I have too many people. I have a couple people who've literally have told me that they've been abducted, and then they have something within their body. So the thing that they have within their body are, it's technology from the future. And this technology does different things. And I have somebody I know that's close to me that actually has technology from the future. Okay. And this person had been abducted, and they basically put this technology within them. And then they told this person that this technology is going to help them in the coming years, with this whole ascension process. So I believe the technology is there and able to help them harbor their soul within this ascension process with all the information that's coming in, all the light that's coming in. I think it's going to help them transmute into the higher aspects of this reality of what's going on right now. Who knows? This is just my thought process. I have no idea. This is just my thought process. But yes, I do know a couple people who have technology within their physical vessel, and they have this technology within them in order for the ETs to know where they're at and then to read their vital signs to make sure that everything is going good with them. But yeah, I just wanted to get that out there. And that's why they said they're in contact with over 5 million humans, because you're literally in their database, literally. But yeah, damn, yeah, I'm tired as hell. Let's see. God damn.
Nothing.
Ooh, 4 minutes. You know what? I'm not even going to talk. We're just going to let this ride. Let's get it.
With you, we've had to even simulate a conversation where you speak first, then us, then you. We've had to edit our dialogue in order for your mind to understand. From our perspective, this conversation, which we are perceiving as a very different medium, was, is, and will be. And we must say, we are delighted.
Okay. I think I understand. But you guys obviously have space, right? I mean, I'm me and you're you guys.
No. Even that we've had to simulate in order to keep you calm and keep your mind and consciousness in its own element. If you were where we are all now, we have reasons to believe it would be an unpleasant, horrific experience for you.
Okay, so what is it you want? How can I help you?
Please allow us to tell you more about us. We are a collective consciousness. Beings, varied and intelligent, the infinite majority of us from completely different planes of existence. The infinite majority of us are not from your universe, nor metaverse, nor are most of our planes even closely related by a degree comprehensible by the human mind. Despite the vastness of all that is, all beings, things, entities, and all that encompasses us and connects us to us and all that is, there is a connection which binds us all, called the network.
The network? Like in the movie The Matrix?
No, and vastly more complex, actually. All life on your planet, all non-life, all things, events, seen and unseen, tangible and intangible, are connected to the network. All your planets, galaxies, space, molecules, atoms, universes, emptiness, energy fields, all things you can even conceive and cannot conceive in your universe and plane of existence are all connected through the network.
So, if you get, you can equate, what's it called? You can equate the network as this huge this huge computer hardware, okay? Hard drive. You can equate the network to this huge internet hard drive where every single person, every single thing is connected via the very thing that keeps you alive, which is your heart chakra, the toroidal field, because everything is a toroid, okay? So, so everything in Earth, again, everything, if you are on Earth, everything is recorded in the hard drive of Earth. They call it the Akashic, okay? They call it the Akashic. Same thing as a computer. What you go in the database, you go to find information. Any information in the computer is called Akash. C-A-C-H-E. It's called Akash. So when you want to look up information in a computer or anything whatsoever, you find Akash. And if you want to look up any information on Earth whatsoever that's happened on Earth, you go to the Akashic. So everything is connected. So anything Earth has, if you've been on Earth, Earth has your information, including the past lives and the parallel lives that you are currently living or that you have lived or the future lives that you are living right now. Everything is happening and everything is happening all at once. So these deities, these gods, what these bad ETs, what that's taken over this dimension right now are nothing but our future selves that basically decided to come back and play a game on us, play a trick on us, and basically create a false reality for us to basically get trapped in. That's literally what they're doing. Again, so it's basically the bad kids coming in, taking over the school, and basically putting you on light code lockdown because they know if they put you on light code lockdown, then they can stop you from doing certain things. That's literally what it is. Why? It's just to play a game. Think about how boring it would be if everything was all good all the time. You know what I'm saying? Think about how boring it would be if everything was just a love story. Nothing would be fun about it. There would be no expansion of consciousness. Everybody would be kumbaya, my lord, kumbaya. Everything would be copacetic. There would be no fight. There would be no tussle. The only thing that makes it fun is because there's fighting. The only thing that makes it fun is because there's disagreement. The only thing that makes it fun is because there's opposition. That's the only thing that makes it fun. If there was everything was in agreement, there would be nothing to be had from it. No experience, no consciousness, no awareness, no fun. No fun. You gotta have duality in order to tussle. You need that shit. If there's nothing to tussle with, then you can't grow. So that's where it comes from. You know what I'm saying? That's where it comes from. So were there entertainment? Yes, but it's the same aspect as it's still you. How do you know it's not you coming from the future coming to here to fuck with you? Because that could literally be that. You get what I'm saying? It could literally be that. You were not attached to that aspect of you because this aspect of you decided to stick in this dimension. That's literally what it is. So it can be an aspect of you coming from the future. Be like, you know what? I'm going to go fuck with Fairy Barbie over here or Fairy Gabby. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to go fuck with Fairy Gabby because she told me to. You know what I'm saying? You have no idea. You have no idea. So, goddamn, do I want to continue this? All right, let's continue this.
Other planes of existence are connected to its beings and connected to the network. All planes of existences, including the infinite majority of ours, are connected to the network. The network spans all things and all non-things. It's like an infinite spiderweb which spreads its tentacles through all dimensions, universes, and planes. It connects everything. We are all connected, and at your moment now, so are you in a controlled manner.
You hear that?
I'm connected to this network now? Why in a controlled manner? If all things are connected, how come I don't feel like this regularly when I'm on Earth? This is why you and approximately 5,407,002 humans are here. Why 5,407,003 humans? Why the odd number? And why do you say approximately? It seems like an odd number to you because you humans invented a numerical system based on the number 10.
Mm-hmm.
Ours is based on the best number to acquire the information we need. We say approximately because we are also connected to unborn human fetuses.
You hear that?
In the womb. They are among the most intelligent and consciously aware human beings on Earth.
Damn. Where's this shit?
Wow. We are here to find out information. Being connected to the network means infinite, instant access to any information found anywhere in any universe, in any
place. So the reason why this is important, because they can connect to these beings and they can know who you are. Again, do you understand why a lot of kids go missing?
In extremely simplified terms that you can understand, we can be everywhere,
all at
nowhere,
once,
and anywhere we want, accessing and tapping into all consciousnesses and information. In relevance to you and Earth, all of Earth is connected to the same network, which spans all things everywhere, in all planes beyond anything your mind can comprehend. From the birds in the air that know to migrate and return at the right time, to the tiny spiderlings that know how to spin the most complex silken nets and fish for food, to the crystallization of a speck of water into a snowflake, to the lightning bolt that strikes in a storm, to the very rocks you trod on. You humans don't even know that rocks have consciousness.
Right.
Your earthen rocks and minerals are among the most consciously aware earthen beings so strongly tapped into the network.
Strong as hell.
And humans? This is why we're here. All things are connected to this network, but one entity. The consciousness of the human race. You are unique from any entity we've come across. We have come to you from all points of existence and planes to actively tap into your consciousness, the human consciousness, to discover why you, of all entities among all beings in any plane, are not fully connected to the network.
Now you hear that, right?
You mean people aren't connected to this network? Animals, plants, minerals, substances, space, time, existence, events, energies, concepts, principles, physical and metaphysical by your terms, laws, atoms, your very body, everything in your immediate area are connected to the network. But for some unknown reason which leaves all other beings perplexed, human consciousness is not completely connected to the network.
Because they lack a connection with the network itself. They lack a connection with the soul. They have, most humans, the humans he's talking about, lack a soul. They don't have a connection with the infinite consciousness, with the source itself. This is crazy how they're telling you this in an alien abduction. What the fuck? This is crazy. I've only watched 2 minutes of this, and that's crazy. And when I come across information, it is meant for me to listen, and I share this. You know what I'm saying? If I find it have some importance, I come back and share this. But listen to this shit.
Only beings we know that are capable of constricting your connection to the network. So we humans are not connected at all. Why? Yes, humans are connected, some more than others, but it seems none of you, save a few individuals, as well as a tribal human race in a remote island in the Pacific, are 100% connected past infancy and childhood.
You hear that?
You have experienced brief points of connection when you have psychic moments, intuitive experiences, inspired action, and when you're in complete joy. The moments you personally were the most connected to the network were the first few years after your birth, select events like when you made the top 10 on Canadian Idol, and every time you have fulfilling, intense sexual intercourse with another, a group of others, or yourself.
Wow.
We are here to learn why you humans largely disconnect yourself from the network so willingly and naturally.
Mm-hmm.
We want to learn how you were able to cut yourselves off from all that is. Humanity is the largest crux to all of us.
How can we connect to the network 100%?
So they know what they did exactly willingly. So they know what they did. See, you see what I'm saying? Playing God. You hear this shit? Do you hear literally in your face, exposing themselves, literally?
How did you find us humans?
Basically, when everything is connected to the network, all consciousness is connected, and we essentially know where every entity is, and we feel them.
Now, you hear this? So there is no hiding. There is no hiding from anything because they know.
Everyone can feel each other. However, human consciousness to us is like a minute pinhole in a never-ending quilt of consciousness. We have taken great lengths to locate human consciousness. Your earthen beings, planet, elements, minerals, gases, and plants and animals who are connected to the network had to guide us to your consciousness location, even though they themselves had troubles finding a bearing on your location to help us find you, because you humans are so disconnected from the rest of us. It took the aid of humans from different places and different times who were 100% connected to the network to give us proper directions to find you.
That makes sense. That's why the Nomos were amongst the first ones to come down here and give the Dogon the information of the stars. That makes a lot of sense.
You, as in your consciousness. We knew where your physical body was, again, because it is naturally connected to the network. But we are delighted because we are now connecting with your perplexing human consciousness. A controlled connecting.
So why a controlled connection? You mean I'm not 100% connected now? How come I can't feel the vastness of your collective consciousness?
No,
Our connecting right now is more like a one-way mirror, with drawings made on the mirror on your end so that you remain calm and comfortable. If you are to be 100% connected right now, we have every reason to believe you would be completely terrified of the expanse that is. There would be shock, like turning on a bright spotlight after living in darkness your whole life.
Mm-hmm.
Only this is a very mild simile.
Now, now think about that. Think about that, that analogy he just used. Think about that. Could it, again, because we are light itself, this is what's happening to us about now with the sun shining upon us. Again, the sun is getting hotter. It's getting brighter. We are luminous light beings. More light is being shed upon us because we are light beings. Because the sun is becoming more light, we too are going to start emanating more light out. It's going to become a light planet. A light planet. This is what the this planet is ascending to. Dang, I forgot what I was going to talk about, though. I forgot where I was going
to head. You're not abducting me to perform freak studies on my body with tools and probes?
No. In fact, we find the human body and brain to be the most basic of Earth and life forms. And certainly, hypothetically speaking, if we were from your universe and were like students attempting to study the most technologically advanced life form on the planet Earth, it would be leafcutter ants. Studying humans to us would be like growing a chia pet to you. This is what the extraterrestrials from your universe, as well as others, have consistently found on your planet over the millions of years that they've been studying Earth.
So there have been aliens studying us? Studying Earth?
Yes, many, many beings studying all aspects of your planet. And we have direct access to their findings.
Because of the network.
Precisely. Only most of the studying was done astrally through the network, and not physically like is portrayed in your movies. Beings from your universe and related universes are bound by time, so they in fact had to study Earth through sequence while accessing the network.
You hear that?
The infinite majority of us, however, are not from your universe or related universes with the aspect of time, and we already know and are one with all, including those ever-advanced leafcutter ants. But we are not 100% connected to human consciousness, again, which remains the greatest mystery to us. In this connecting, we are studying you now. And so are your very Earth and planet mates, entities, and objects.
So someone's playing.
So does any of this have to deal with the year 2012?
That is the year humans will return to 100% lifelong connection to the network.
You hear this?
Lifelong?
Yes, all humans are 100% connected to the network when they are born, but slowly gain the ability to disconnect as they grow older. Afterwards, they have brief, often semi or mini connections.
Again, so this is why. So as a child, you're living in the moment. So you're experiencing the moment at all times. So you experience no time. So you are a high vibrational being, you know. So children experience high vibrational moments. And this is why they're also the most susceptible to mind programming. They are in the theta wave frequency throughout their whole life up till 7 years. So they have the most fun because they're living in the present moment. Time doesn't exist to them. And this is what you're going to figure out as well. You can't fathom this right now. You can't fathom this. Hold on.
This is what happens 99 to disconnect as they grow older.
In the sense, so as you grow older, you start to disconnect from that consciousness. You start to disconnect. And because you're still connected to the grid just a little bit through Earth, you start to get little bursts of this. That's why you experience moments of miracles, or like what you would call miracles. Something amazing happens. You manifest something, you would call it miracles. So this is just a burst of your creator powers manifesting in this reality, because you don't have that infinite light awareness in order to manifest the what you want into this physical reality, because again, you're not a physical being. It's difficult to basically be something that you're not. You're not physical, you're metaphysical. So it's easier for you to manifesting in the metaphysical. So you're not used to working with this dense light. You come here in this density in order to experience what it's like to work with density again. So you experience little bursts of miracles throughout your whole life, but right now is going to be even more. So again, manifestations are happening instantaneously now. I'm sure some of you guys are experiencing this right now because more light, more awareness, more conscious, more energy is being produced onto this planet. So beautiful, isn't it? So beautiful.
Afterwards, they have brief, often semi or mini connections. Again, this is what happens 99.999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 and they also helped us find your location. So how can I help you find out how I'm able to disconnect?
We have the answer already. As we have said before, we had to simulate a conversation with sequence and human dialogue. Mm. From our perspective, the conversation is very different. All answers are revealed. We are delighted.
So what's the answer? How are we able to disconnect from the network? I want to be 100% connected to the network. It sounds like an awesome connection.
The year 2012 will be a remembering of how to do that. Meanwhile, try to remember what it was like being a newborn infant. If you search really hard and reach deep into your consciousness, you will regain the connection to the network. Mm. Until then, we bid you farewell.
Farewell? Are we done?
Yes, human. We are delighted with this connecting.
Yes, human.
As we mentioned, you will be rewarded. Upon your return to your earthen state, it will take you 13 hours to remember this entire conversation. Our reward for you will be a complete recording of this conversation inscribed in your mind with the utmost clarity. You will write it down and send it off to the world and will thereby be a beneficiary to your kind.
My God, this is all so much to handle.
Jesus, Michael Jackson, Gandhi, Mother Teresa, Hitler, and many others, some not even born yet, have handled much more than you. You will be fine. Goodbye.
Yo. Yo, that must be a Draco, boy. He did him cold. Oh, my God. He did him cold. Yo. My boy did him cold. Oh, my God. Listen, y'all. Now, that's beautiful. So now, as you see, this is all a game. It's all a mind game. It's all a thought process. Thoth, you know what I'm saying? It's all, everything has been thought. Everything has been thought. There's nothing that has not been thought. Your thought holds weight. So again, now, what are you doing this very moment? Ask yourself that question. What are you doing this very moment? Okay. Are you living in your purpose this very moment? Since we know time doesn't exist, are you literally living in your purpose at this moment? And if not, then whose purpose are you living in? Yeah, we've been tricked for a while. But awareness is coming to the surface. More light is becoming to the surface. More intelligence is coming to the surface. You see all this upheaval, all this uproar that's going on. This is happening because of you. The fire, the kundalini energy that's burning throughout the earth right now via the sun is burning within you right now. I say this right now because a lot of people are literally working and walking in the purpose of others. And the reason why I say this is because doesn't the body have a mind of its own? So are you walking in your purpose or are you walking in the purpose of this physical vessel that you are not. Because this physical vessel is tied to this earth. And with this programming that you receive in this earth over time, this gets embedded into the DNA of this vessel as well. And I say that because this physical vessel may not be allowing you to fulfill your purpose. So you must take over control. You must take control of this physical vessel because you are the one that's in charge. Without you, this wouldn't exist. The very first thing that you are is the thought process itself. The energy source that's coming together in order to create this this great experience that we're all co-creating right now. It's such a beautiful thing that I'm able to speak to other versions of myself just to see how we're on the same frequency. Whether you're here, whether you're there, you're just an aspect of me that I get to talk to. Some of y'all are more closer than my family members, people that I would call my cousins, people that I don't even talk to because they're not in the same vibration as me. It's all about vibration, about frequency, what makes you who and what we are. Now, ask yourself a question. What are you doing in order to better yourself? In fact, the sun's going to show you. It's going to get tough. It's going to get tough because this is preparing you to become the better version of yourself. This is called the superhero time. You're becoming a superhero. And the word hero comes from the higher self. And the higher self, what? Is the sun. That's why the sun is shining the brightest on you right now, because you are a hero. And it wants to show you that. So it's shining that light upon you. It's literally doing that. You need to get out there and become the superhero. Inquire more light within this physical vessel, because that light that's permeating throughout the earth, that the sun is emitting, that's you. That's pieces of your consciousness and awareness downloading into this beautiful vessel. I want you to understand and know that you are only becoming the higher, greatest version of yourself every single day, every single second. I appreciate your love, y'all. Thank y'all for being here. Thank you for tuning in. You only tune into my frequency because you resonate with the information that I have. Safe travel to the astral. Protect yourself. Stay hydrated. Fruit water. Nothing less. Because you deserve the best. All right, y'all. I appreciate love, y'all. Peace, y'all. Peace, man.